Hi, this is Arash and welcome to the Epoxy channel. In this channel, we're going to talk about the epoxy resins from the theoretical aspects to the most practical ones. So if this is the first video that you're watching or if you're interested in epoxy resins, please like and subscribe to our channel for more videos.
Today, I'm going to present Bisphenol A epoxy resins. Bisphenol A is a chemical compound primarily used in the manufacture of various plastics. It is a colorless solid which is soluble in most common organic solvents but has very poor solubility in water. The chemical formula is C15H16O2 and it is a white solid with a molar mass of 228.3. Density is 1.217 and melting point is 155 centigrade and the flash point is 227. BPA is produced on the industrial scale by the condensation reaction of phenol in acetone, as shown here. Global production in 2022 was estimated to be almost 10 million tons. BPA's largest single application is as a co-monomer in the production of polycarbonates, which accounts for 65 to 70% of all BPA production. The manufacturing of epoxy resins in vinyl ester resins accounts for 25 to 30% of BPA use. The remaining 5% is used as a major component of several high-performance plastics, as a minor additive in PVC, polyurethane, thermal paper, and several other materials. Regarding the health effects of BPA, it should be mentioned that BPA is a xenoestrogen, exhibiting hormone-like properties that mimic the effect of estrogen in the body. Although the effect is very weak, the pervasiveness of BPA counting materials raises concerns as exposure is effectively lifelong. BPA containing materials include coatings for the inside of food cans, clothing designs, shop receipts, and dental fillings. BPA has been investigated by public health agencies in many countries as well as by the WHO. While normal exposure is below the level currently associated with risk, several jurisdictions have taken steps to reduce exposure on a precautionary basis, in particular by banning BPA from baby bottles. The largest exposure humans have had to BPA is from food packaging, particularly the epoxy lining of metal food, beverage cans, and plastic bottles. BPA-free plastics have also been introduced, which are manufactured using alternative bisphenols, such as bisphenol S and bisphenol F. But there is also a controversy around whether these are actually safer. The synthesis of bisphenol A was first reported in 1891, by the Russian chemist Alexander Dianin. It was impure. In 1905, Zinke synthesized pure bisphenol A BPA from acetone and phenol. About 25 to 30% of BPA is used in the manufacture of epoxy resin and vinyl ester resins. The most common epoxy resin are based on reacting epichlorohydrin ECH with bisphenol A, resulting in a chemical substance known as bisphenol A diglycidyl ether, commonly known as BADGE. For epoxy resin, it is first converted to its diglycidyl ether. This is achieved by a reaction with epichlorohydrin under basic conditions. The reaction between bisphenols and epichlorohydrin followed by dehydrohalogenation yields bifunctional epoxy, as illustrated, and bisphenol A diglycidyl adder DGEBA is produced. The chlorine atom is released as sodium chloride, NaCl, and the hydrogen atom as water. The compound is colorless, viscous liquid. Commercial samples can appear pale, straw colored. It is a key component of many epoxy resin formulations. Moreover, diglycidyl ether bisphenol A reacts with acrylic acid to give vinyl ester resins, which are discussed later in a separate video on epoxy acrylates. The reaction results in the opening of epoxide ring, generating unsaturated esters at each terminus of the molecule. Such materials are often diluted with styrene and converted to resin. Bisphenol A diglycidyl ether-based epoxy coatings are extensively used for coating the inside of cans that come into contact with food and thus food contact materials. Regarding its safety, bisphenol A diglycidyl ether is highly reactive and forms a number of species upon exposure to water or HCl, and many of these compounds, including bisphenol A diglycidyl ether, are suspected endocrine disruptors. Hydrolysis of the ether bonds liberates bisphenol A, which is also strongly suspected of being an endocrine disruptor. From the 1990s onward, concern has been raised over the use of bisphenol A diglycidyl air-based epoxy resins in the lining of some cans for foodstuffs, with the chemical being found to leach into foods. At a 10-to-1 ratio of epichlorohydrin to bisphenol A, the monomer content in the product mixture is called 90%. These mixtures are called low molecular resins. Higher molecular weight diglycidyl ethers, N bigger than 1, are formed by the reaction of bisphenol A diglycidyl ether formed with further bisphenol A. This is called prepolymerization. A product comprising a few repeat units, for example N equal 1 to 2, is a viscous clear liquid. This is called a liquid epoxy resins. A product comprising more repeating units, for example N equal to 2 to 13, is at room temperature a colorless solid, which is correspondingly referred to as a solid epoxy resin. Increasing the ratio of bisphenol A to epichlorohydrin during manufacture produces higher molecular weight linear polyethers with glycidyl end groups, which are semi-solid to hard crystalline materials at room temperature, depending on the molecular weight achieved. This route of synthesis is known as the Taffy process or shell process. Herein, we have the controlled excess of epichlorohydrin. The usual route to higher molecular weight epoxy resin is to start with liquid epoxy resins or LER and add a calculated amount of bisphenol A, and then a catalyst is added and the reaction heated to 116 centigrade. This process is known as advancement, also called the fusion method. Herein, we have controlled the excess of pre-synthesized diglycidyl ether bisphenol A monomer. As the molecular weight of the resin increases, the epoxide content reduces and the material behaves more and more like a thermoplastic. Very high molecular weight poly condensates, for example, 3,000 to 70,000 gram per mole, form a class known as phenoxy resins and contain virtually no epoxy groups. Since the terminal epoxy groups are insignificant compared to the total size of the molecule. These resins do, however, contain hydroxyl groups throughout the backbone, which may also undergo other cross-linking reactions, for example, with aminoplast, phenoplast and isocyanates. Worth to repeat here that the epoxy value is expressed as the epoxide equivalent weight, which is the ratio between the molecular weight and the number of epoxide groups. EEW has been explained in a separate video in detail. This parameter is used to calculate the mass of the co-reactant hardener to use when curing epoxy resins. Epoxies are typically cured with stoichiometric or near stoichiometric quantities of hardener to achieve the best physical properties. As it has been mentioned, Taffy or Shell process is the reaction of BPA with the controlled excess of epichlorohydrin. It is a one-step process for the polycondensation of bisphenol A and epichlorohydrin under the reaction of NaOH, that is, the ring opening and ring closure reactions are carried out under the same reaction conditions. It is commonly used in the synthesis of low and medium molecular weight epoxy resins. The reaction yields a two-phase mixture of alkaline sodium chloride solution and aqueous epoxy resin solution. Medium to high molecular weight resins can be produced based on these routes. The domestic E44 epoxy resin is synthesized by a one-step process. Here, the product is obtained by separating the phase, washing the resin, and removing the water by distillation. Herein, a low molar ratio, less than 3 moles of epichlorohydrin to bisphenol A, and stoichiometric amounts of sodium hydroxide are used. In this table, we can see the properties of various resins based on different ratios of ECH to BPA. As the portion of ECH is decreasing, molecular weight and EEW are increased. The resultant resin is less active and the melting point is also increasing. The Taffy process is used in industry up to values of N equal to 3.7. Taffy method can be divided into a water washing method, a solvent extraction method, and a solvent method, which is a polycondensation reaction of bisphenol A and epichlorohydrin under the reaction of NaOH for producing a medium molecular weight solid epoxy resin. Domestically produced E20, E14, E12 and other epoxy resins are basically used based on this method. The advancement process is a two-step process with the reaction of bisphenol A and epichlorohydrin under the reaction of a catalyst such as a quaternary ammonium salt. The first step by an addition reaction to form a diphenyl propane chlorohydrin ether intermediate, and the second step is carried out in the presence of NaOH. A closed-loop reaction produces an epoxy resin. The advantages of the two-step process are reaching a short reaction time, experiencing stable operation, having a small temperature fluctuation. The process is easy to control. We have a short alkali addition time. We can avoid large-scale hydrolysis of epichlorohydrin. The product quality is good and stable, and the yield is high. The domestic E51 and E54 epoxy resins are synthesized by a two-step process. The Diglycidyl adder bisphenol A and bisphenol A reacts at 150 to 190 centigrade in the presence of the catalyst. The advancement process differs from the Taffy process in that it only yields resins with an average with an even number of monomers, for example, N equal to 0, 2, 4. The advancement method can be divided into bulk polymerization method and a catalytic polymerization method. After the low molecular weight liquid, E-type epoxy resin and bisphenol A are heated and dissolved. The addition reaction is carried out under the action of high temperature or a catalyst. Continuously expanding the chain and finally forming a high molecular weight solid epoxy resin. Domestically produced E10, E06, E03 and other epoxy resin are produced in this way. A range of compounds used as catalyst has been presented here. Bisphenol-based epoxy resins are categorized by molecular weight, number of epoxy groups, number of OH groups, melting point, and viscosity. Based on molecular weight, they can be classified into low molecular weight, which are liquid epoxy resins, middle molecular weight resins, high molecular weight resins, and very high molecular weight epoxies. Epoxy groups per mole imply the number of epoxy groups, and when it is higher, it means that the number of epoxy groups per one mole of resin is higher. Technically, it means that the resin is more active. The trend of hydroxyl group is reversed, and a higher hydroxyl value points to a higher molecular weight and a less active resin. By increasing the molecular weight of bisphenol A resins, the melting point is increasing, and for very high molecular weight resins, it reaches 116, whereas low molecular weight resins are liquid at room temperature. A list of good solvents for bisphenol A epoxy resins has been presented here. Bisphenol A liquid epoxy resins are used in broad application, including coatings, civil engineering, adhesives, electrical insulating materials, and reactive intermediates. Properties of bisphenol A epoxy resins have been presented here for interested engineers. Here you can see the relative performance of different epoxies. In this case, a comparison between properties of bisphenol A epoxies, bisphenol F epoxies, and Novalac epoxies have been presented. It should be noted that these properties are case-dependent, but this table can be considered as a general guide. In terms of adhesion, all resins perform fine, meaning all of them show good enough adhesion to different substrates. Compared to the other resin, bisphenol A epoxies show a tendency for crystallization, which is one of their drawbacks. Moreover, compared to bisphenol F and Novalac systems, these resins are more chemically vulnerable. Novalacs are the best options when chemical resistance is required. In terms of UV resistance, bisphenol A is kind of limited. Thermal stability of this resin is also comparably low. However, the economy may compensate all these drawbacks and make the bisphenol A epoxy resins often the first option. Therefore, this is the most common epoxy resin used by the industry sector. Roughly speaking, the wholesale price of bisphenol A resin is around $3 per kilogram, whereas Novalac are traded at $4 to $5 per kilogram, and bisphenol F epoxies are traded at $5 per kilogram. These prices are average prices from the Alibaba website from different vendors on July 2023. The prices may be subjected to change, but the trend might stay more or less similar. The comparison between different epoxy resin is also provided here for bisphenol A, bisphenol F, Novalac, and polyglycol resins for more elaboration. L stands for low, M for medium, and H for high.
Thanks for your attention. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please share your comments, thoughts, or questions, and I will come back to you soon. Thank you.